not the Caribbean I imagined, but this will do. We're just pulling into Shelter Bay. Very exciting day. And I can't believe that we are in the Caribbean.
Well, we already had a celebratory tequila with the boys.
Cheers!
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 Thank you for everything, attention.
But now we are going to Boundless for the good stuff. Apparently it's champagne.
Champagne for everyone! And welcome to the Caribbean. I can't quite believe that we're here. It's just amazing to me that you can spend a day motoring across a continent and arrive on a different ocean. It's just crazy.
But enough of that nonsense. Let's get the champagne.
Yeah!
Oh, look at that.
Boys, congratulations.
Hey, you guys.
Yes.
Hello.
Hugs.
Congratulations.
Well done. Well done.
Good driving today.
You too.
That's awesome. I can't believe we're here.
Yeah.
We're like, you're so weird.
So, as I said, champagne take. Let's just wait for the French fries.
Yes. Everybody cover your heads.
Yes.
I can't get it. My fingers are too wet.
It's going straight for French fries.
Oh my God. Don't worry, Peter, you'll get your 18 minutes of video right here.
In the next episode of Sailing Bohemia.
George, it's coming up.
Well, that was an anti-climax. Talking of anti-climax, I've got a good story about that. But I think I need a few more of those.
Okay, right. Welcome to the Caribbean!
Cheers, guys!
Oh. Mm. It tastes so much different in the Caribbean.
Oh, yes. I think it's the white beaches and the blue water. What do you think?
And the sunshine.
Yeah.
The clear blue skies.
Good morning from the Caribbean paradise. Day one, and I love it already. Big day today. We need to organize the boat. We need to clean the boat. We need to put back all the solar panels. But before that, we need to repair our bimini. So the sewing machine is coming out. We also have the team coming back. By team, I mean my team. The people under me. The handliners coming back to collect all of their lines and fenders. So it's not a pure relaxation today, but it's all very exciting that we made it. Oh, that reminds me, I need to take a good omen off as well. I think I'm gonna hide it on Boundless's boat again, just like they did.
Well, what a day we had yesterday. Starting at 4 a.m, it was a long one, but everything went really smoothly. I still can't believe that we're here. It's really amazing that motoring just 40 miles can take you across a continent and between oceans. It was a real adventure. We went up 85 feet above sea level, sailing through Gatun Lake. Certainly the first time for Bohemia sailing above sea level, and in freshwater for the first time. Another bit of amazing history. This is a real bucket list item, traveling through one of the wonders of the modern world. And much of it still working as it was designed over 100 years ago. Those locks are just impressive pieces of machinery. So the captain got to geek out and got his fill of admiration for the old machines. Another old machine that's still going strong is Bohemia, of course. Her 20-year-old engine did us proud. We took her up to the max pretty much for the whole day. Yesterday, and we managed about 6.6 to 6.8 knots, which got us through in one day, thankfully. We're so glad that we didn't need to spend the night in Gatun Lake. We're really glad that we hired the professional line handlers this time. We were umming and ahhing about what to do there, but they just knew exactly what to do at exactly the right moment. In fact, I didn't see the first mate tugging on a single line the whole day.
I didn't. Management, you see, management.
Yeah, he slipped straight into his management role as soon as he had a team of people beneath him.
It's a bit dry. I make my more moist, just saying.
Didn't get his hands dirty after that. Every time the gates of the locks opened in front of us, we just had a rush of adrenaline.
Caribbean! We're nearly in the Caribbean!
And we were really eager to get to the other side and see what was waiting for us. And here we are, of course, in the gorgeous Caribbean. It looks just like all the photos in the magazines. It's exactly what the first mate's been looking forward to. And to reward the first mate in achieving our accomplishment yesterday, we got an extra special dose of deck scrubbing. It's quite dirty. We had a lot of people walking up and down there yesterday. So he's gonna get to what he loves the most, some boat chores.
First day in the Caribbean is going really well. Exactly what I dreamt of. Wouldn't wish for anything else.
It's all hands on deck today. It's a departure day. Finally, I got to admit, it has been a wonderful reset to be in the marina for a few days. In fact, it was so wonderful that I have caught some virus, COVID or ear infection something, and I was on antibiotics for 4 days. All good now and we are ready to leave. Gonna be heading to Bocas del Toro area, which we have high hopes for. Captain has been very busy getting the boat ship shape.
That's right, it's been work, work, work the whole time we've been in this marina, sadly. Well, for one of us who wasn't ill anyway, conveniently. Sadly, and rather embarrassingly, the captain hasn't even left the marina. So next time when we come back, we're going to explore the area and have a look around a little bit.
I don't think we have missed much anyway, because the only area which is interesting around here is Colon, and there have been some civil unrest and road blockages and protests and tear gas and all of that. So we don't want to be caught up in all of that. So I think it was the perfect time for the first mate to claim his sick bay. And I swear it was a real sickness, that it wasn't just a scheme to stay in a marina for longer with the AC running. I swear, I wouldn't do that, would I?
Don't believe a word of it, captains. As soon as that AC came on, so did the earache.
It's not my fault, I've been infected. It's the marina infection.
Right, let's get out of here before the next infection strikes.
Got to stay for another month. And now comes the sad part. We are saying goodbye, almost for good, to Boundless, Colin and Julian, who has accompanied us all the way from Chiapas. So we have sailed maybe 2,500 miles together for the last 5 months. The boys are staying here, they are hauling out, and hopefully we will see them again in the next season, but you know, you never know. So it's a bit sad. I hope they baked a goodbye cake or pizza or something to give us for the journey, you know, as you do.
No pressure.
No pressure at all. So let's see what they got.
They finally managed to get rid of us after 2,500 miles. So do be careful who you choose to buddy boat with. Sometimes they can be rather sticky. That's us in this case, not them.
This is the moment.
This is it.
This is it.
2,000 miles and you finally got managed to get rid of us.
We have a little gift for you.
Ah, I was joking that they're going to have a gift. No, they do. See, this is what real friends are like.
You shouldn't have.
It is a... It's a Boundless morning cocktail glass. And it comes with a little bit of Kahlua.
Oh, wonderful.
We were going to put amaretto in, but Bohemia's crew drunk it all the other night.
Oh, fantastic. Thank you so much.
That's amazing. We're going to think of you every time we have a morning cocktail.
Thank you so much for this in the end of October.
Now, you're going to be all right without us?
Don't.
Do you know the way?
We'll be back probably in half an hour, you know. The other ear is going to ache next.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
It's not my fault I had the marina infection.
I told you they are everywhere. Right. See you later.
Get the spenders in. You don't want to look
amateur. We've got a Barbie doll on the rigging. Why do you think I mind about our fenders?
Something tells me she'll find her way back.
Yeah.
Well, 10 short minutes of motoring later, out of our slip, and for the first time ever, we're sailing on the Atlantic. The Atlantic Ocean with little Bohemia. Can you believe it? I keep pinching myself. It's going to feel really weird, I think, for two reasons. Firstly, cruising with our good friends, Boundless. I'm going to have to do all my own navigation now. I can't just blindly follow them. Passage planning, the lot of it. I have to bring back all those long lost skills. And also sailing on a whole new cruising ground, a whole new ocean, different side of the planet. It's just incredible. We've got exactly 100 miles to go on this passage, and we'll be in our passage anchorage of a little beautiful island. Here's hoping for flat seas and no wind.
So, you know, as one door closes, another open, we are actively looking for a new buddy boat, better boat, more committed friends who do not go flying off to North America and Europe and leave us on our own. So it could be you. You never know. Let us know. Look us up. We don't sound desperate at all.
That's right. If you think you've got what it takes to put up with the first mate 24/7 on the radio, and let's face it, next door to you in the anchorage, then leave us a comment. The lines are open.
The only issue with Panama is that it's really in the middle of the doldrums, so there isn't any wind to speak of, and all wind we get is a bit of a sea breeze, a bit of land breeze, but nothing significant. So today we have a 100-mile passage ahead of us, but we're not hoping for much. So there's a bit of a breeze right now, and the captain got all excited and starts pulling the main out. I said that due to my illness, I still can't pull any lines, obviously. The doctor wouldn't be happy, would he?
Suddenly, the doctor's the most important person in his life. As soon as he starts writing sick notes. Yeah, we got a little bit of wind. I think it's from these approaching clouds. So we're gonna get the main out and see what we can do. But I think the engine's gonna be on for most of these 100 miles.
So negative, isn't he? I've always said it.
And I also think the first mate's gonna be in his favorite spot, sheltering under the dodger just there for at least 90 of those 100 miles. It's not his fault. He's unfit to work.
I've been prescribed peace and quiet.
I wish someone would prescribe me peace and quiet. Never give up hope. Well, that's me done for the next 100 miles. Sails out, engines on. I'm gonna see about getting my peace and quiet prescription now. Well, this is a turn up for the books. I wasn't expecting to be sailing. Maybe the captain's not gonna get the rest he was expecting on this passage. Let's see what we get from this.
So far, so good. We are 2 hours on our way. Not super fast, around 3.5 knots, but hey, it's for free.
If we keep it up like this, then we'll be arriving tomorrow night. But I have a feeling the wind is gonna die or change, and we can catch up under diesel power.
Lately, he likes his diesel power, I've got to admit. You should have seen him in the Panama Canal. He was going like 7 knots. There was no stopping him.
Just call me Speedy Gonzales.
Diesel Gonzales, more like.
There is something to be said for getting there quickly, I suppose. But as soon as I got the fuel bill when we topped up in this marina, I soon snapped out of it, so don't worry. We'll still be sailing Bohemia for the time being.
I'm a natural, you see. Years of experience. Can't buy that.
He's right, you know, I tried. And look what I got.
I'm the mail order first, man. I came all the way from the east.
Special thanks in this episode go to all of our patrons for keeping Bohemia's crew from running dry. If you've been enjoying our episodes and would like to buy us a drink, then please head over to www.patreon.com/sailingbohemia, where you'll find a small menu of our favorite cocktails to choose from.
Champagne for everyone.
Thank you so much, and here's to you. If
you enjoyed this episode, then please don't forget to tell YouTube all about it by commenting, liking, and sharing. See you next time.